Yesterday, PNC found an illegal dump site on GovGuam property. Apparently, Guam Power Authority crews discovered the trash while clearing vegetation underneath their power lines in Nimitz Hill. The trash was comprised of various types of waste, some which appear to be household items like aluminum drink cans and bottles, while other trash was of a different nature. For example, we found one empty bottle of hydrochloric acid, along with some metallic waste. Totomalik attorney Curtis Vandeveld says this trash does not belong to Totomalik.
Totomalik wants to make clear that this is not illegal dumping by Totomalik, and to in any way suggest that it is not correct.
While the dump site is on GovGuam property, the owners of Totomalik live on and own the property surrounding the dump site. Today, their crews and some family members were at the site cleaning the trash.
Quite often, the Micronesian Divers Association and other goodwill entities on Guam engage in beach cleanup. No one would assume that by their engaging in beach cleanup or cleaning up what is illegally dumped trash, that means that it's their responsibility or that they were the ones who put it there. And so it's really not accurate to draw that conclusion is the point that we're trying to make, simply because of the fact that they're cleaning it up. The area is a GovGuam easement, but it runs behind the residence of one of Totomalik's owners, which is Maria.
Previously, this area was used as a storage facility for their business, as evidenced in this file footage shot by PNC back in 2007. In fact, in 2006, Totomalik was issued a notice of violation and a stop work order by DPW for operating their business in this residential area without the proper permits. PNC has also obtained a letter showing that the Guam EPA denied their application for a conditional use and zone change in that area because of complaints made to Guam EPA. The complaints allege ongoing disposal and discharge of washdown waters and wastewater on site, possible discharge of wastewater into waters of Guam and the Mosel River, and solid waste disposal.
Just because somebody makes an accusation doesn't mean it's true, right? And if you really look at the files, there's been no notice of violation ever issued to Totomalik by Guam EPA. As far as I am aware, there is nothing, no piece of trash whatsoever that bears any markings that indicates it is from Totomalik. There's no porta potty walls or any kind of plumbing materials that suggest that it originates from Totomalik.
So why is Totomalik cleaning up the mess?
Totomalik has been a good business partner to a number of people in this community. It has engaged in providing good services to the community through now two decades, and it wants to maintain its good relationship in the public. And so it has engaged in part to help try to clean up the debris, because it affects the residences. The residences are close by. They don't want any contamination. That's like saying that they're contaminating the place where they live. They don't want that to be the case. So they are trying to do some part of the cleanup. To what extent they're going to be able to clean up the mess? It appears at this point, the surface cleaning is a significant burden in and of itself, and they have engaged in doing the large part of the surface cleaning. The subterranean cleaning, I mean, it's just too expensive. It's probably beyond their abilities to do so. But, they, because they live next to the property, are concerned, and so are going to continue out of good conscience and for their own self-protection to remove the debris